In this video, we're going to look at the new Harmonize filter, which enables us to match the colors and the tones of different photos when we combine them in Photoshop. So here's a background layer with a photo on top. Notice the background layer is very moody and the photo on top is a warmer tone. So one of the challenges we sometimes have when compositing or combining images is making those tones and colors match. But let's have a look at the latest neural filter inside of Photoshop. And notice we have our couple selected. And then we're going to go under Filter. Under Filter, go down to Neural Filters. They're going to pop open. And the one we're looking for is Harmonization. If you don't see it there and you see this little icon, just click on the cloud and that will download it. Now watch what happens. I'm going to turn on this filter. And then it's going to enable me to choose a layer for a reference image. That's going to be the background there. So choose the layer. And of course, there's only one other layer. If there was others, we would see them. And we want to harmonize to this background. So click on the background and watch what happens. Boom. See how it adjusts the tones. Now we have the ability to fine tune it. And I believe we need to do a little bit more on this one here. And what I want to do is take the saturation down a little bit. So let's reduce the saturation. And it takes a second. Notice it reduced the saturation maybe a little bit more. And then when it did that, notice things look a little bit bright. So let's take the brightness down as well. A bit more, maybe even more. And I feel like this is looking a lot better. Now, if you want to touch up individual areas, you can grab these icons here and you could go into the certain areas and you could touch those up manually. Now, when we're done, we can put this onto a new layer or a smart filter. I'm going to choose a smart filter, click OK. And because it's a smart filter, we have the ability to turn that on or off. So we can see the before and we can see the after. And of course, if we want to go back in there, we can do that just by double clicking the smart filter. So this is part of my series on the new features inside of Photoshop 2022. Check out the other videos I have. And if you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. And anyway, guys, if you like this in any way, do me a favor and smash that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And drop us a comment. Let me know, what do you think of this filter? Do you think this is going to be really helpful? I'm curious. Let me know in the comments underneath. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.